Hello students, this is your English lesson. In this lesson, we are going to read a story, The Cruel Crane, unit number 9 from Oxford Reading Circle 5. Let's get started. Long ago, a wise spirit lived in a willow tree. Willow, a tree that grows near water, that stood by a certain lotus pond. Lotus, a type of tropical water lily. It watched the creatures who lived in and around the pond and learned a lot about life. Now, at that time, the water in the pond used to run short by the dry season, even though the pond was not over large. It contained a good many fish. A crane who was cruel and heartless visited one day. He was hungry. As he stood by the bank, he saw the fish and thought, "I must outwit these fish somehow or other and make a prey of them." And he went and sat down at the edge of the water, thinking how he should do it. When the fish saw him, they hid under the lotus leaves and they asked him, "What are you sitting there for?" "Lost in thought, I am sitting thinking about you," said he. "Oh sir, what are you thinking about us?" they asked. "Why," he replied, "there is very little water in this pond and but little for you to eat, and the heat is so great. So I was thinking, what in the world will these fish do now?" "Yes, indeed, sir. What are we to do?" they cried. "If you will only do as I ask you, I will take you in my beak to a fine large pond covered with all the kinds of lotuses and put you into it," answered the crane. "That crane should take thought for the fishes is a thing unheard of. Sir, since the world began, it's eating us one after the other that you are aiming at. Not so long as you trust me, I won't eat you. But if you don't believe me that there is such a pond, send one of you with me to go and see it." Then they trusted him and handed over to him one of their number, a big fellow, blind of one eye, whom they thought sharp enough in any emergency, afloat, ashore. The crane took him and let him go in the pond. He showed the fish the whole of it, brought him back and let him go again close to the other fish, and he told them all the glories of the pond. And when they heard what he said, they exclaimed, "All right, sir, you may take us with you." Then the crane took the whole old half-blind fish first to the bank of the other pond and alighted to come down from something in a willow tree growing on the bank there. But he threw it into a fork of the tree, struck it with his beak and killed it, and then ate its flesh and threw its bones away at the foot of the tree. Then he went back and called out, "I have thrown that fish in. Let another one come." And in that manner he took all the fish one by one and ate them till he came back and found no more. But there was still a crab left behind there. Crab, a sea creature with five pairs of legs. And the crane thought he would eat him too and called out, "I say, good crab, I have taken all the fish away and put them into a fine large pond. Come along, I'll take you too. But how will you take hold of me to carry me along? I will bite hold of you with my beak. You will let me fall if you carry me like that. I won't go with you. Don't be afraid, I will hold you quite tight all the way." Then said the crab to himself, "If this fellow once got hold of fish, he would never let them go in a pond. Now, if he should really put me into the pond, it would be capital. But if he doesn't, then I'll cut his throat and kill him." So he said to him, "Look here, friend, you won't be able to hold me tight enough. But we crabs have a famous grip. If you let me catch hold of you round the neck with my claws, I shall be glad to go with you." And the other did not see that he was trying to outwit him and agreed. So the crab caught hold of his neck with his claws as securely as with a pair of blacksmith's pincers, and instruments having two short handles, and called out, off with you now. And the crane took him and showed him the pond and then turned off towards the willow tree. "Uncle," cried the crab, "the pond lies that way, but you are taking me this way?" "Oh, that's it, is it?" answered the crane. "You dear little uncle, you very sweet nephew, you call me, you mean me to understand, I suppose, that I am your slave, who has to lift you up and carry you about with him. Now look at the heap of fish bones lying at the root of that willow tree. Just as I have eaten those fish, every one of them, just so I will devour you as well. Devour? Eat quickly. Destroy completely. Ah, those fishes got eaten through their own stupidity," answered the crab. "But I am not going to let you eat me. On the contrary, opposite in nature, it is you that I am going to destroy. For you in your folly have not seen," folly, lack of good sense, "folly have not seen that I was outwitting to surpass in cleverness, outwitting you. If you die, we die both together, for I will cut off this head of yours and cast it to the ground." And so saying, he gave the crane's neck a grip with his claws, and as with a vice, wickedness. Then, gasping and with tears trickling from his eyes and trembling with the fear of death, the crane backed him, saying, "Oh, my lord, indeed I did not intend to eat you. Grant me my life." Well, step down into the pond and put me in there." And he turned round and stepped down into the pond and placed the crab on the mud at its edge. But the crab cut through its neck as clean as one would cut a lotus stalk with a hunting knife, and only then entered the water. When the spirit who lived in the willow tree saw this strange affair, he made the wood resound with his plaudits praise, uttering in a pleasant voice the words, "The villain, though exceeding clever, shall prosper not by his villainy. Villainy, criminal behavior. He may win indeed, sharp-witted in deceit, but only as the crane hears from the crab." Now come to the exercises. A. Questions. 1. Why do you think the crane stopped by the pond? Answer. The crane stopped by the pond because he was hungry. 2. What did the crane do to win the trust of the fish? Answer. The crane said he would take the fish to a large pond covered with all kinds of lotuses. 3. Did the fish do the right thing by trusting the crane? Why or why not? Give reasons for your answer. Answer. No, the fish did not do the right thing by trusting the fish. The crane deceived the fish and ate them all one by one. The crane first took one fish in its beak and showed it the large pond. He then brought him back and let him go with the other fish. He told the others all about the pond and they believed the crane. 4. Compare the crab's approach to the crane's proposal to that of the fish. How were the two different? Whose approach was better and why? Answer. The crab knew that the crane had tricked the fish and requested the crane to take him to the pond as well. He told the crane that he would not be able to hold him, so the crab should hold on to the crane's neck instead. The crane agreed, and as soon as he saw the fish bones by the pond, he threatened to cut the crane's neck with his claws. He made the crane step down into the pond and then cut his neck. Whereas the fish were wrong in their approach, as the crane tricked them one by one, they agreed to be taken in its beak and trusted a fish which was blind from one eye. Hence, the approach of the crab was better than that of the fish. 6. What is the moral of the story? Answer. The moral of the story is that even a trickster can be tricked by someone who is clever. B. Reference to context. Read these lines from the story and then answer the questions. 1. I must. Make a pre of them. A. Who says this to whom? Answer. The crane says this to himself. B. What does make a pre of them mean? Answer. Make a pre of them here refers to making the fish his prey in tricking them as well as eating them. C. What does he do after this? Answer. The crane promises to carry the fish in his beak and take them to a large pond. The fish don't trust him, so he takes one fish there first and brings him back. After the fish believe that he wishes them well, he takes them one by one and eats them. 2. Those fishes got eaten through their own stupidity. A. Who says these words and to whom? Answer. The crane says these words to the crab. B. In what way might the fish have been stupid? Answer. The fish may have been stupid to believe that the crane was their well-wisher. C. Do you agree with what he says about the fish? Answer. Yes, I agree. The fish should have given the proposition more thought and should not have trusted the crane. They should have been wary of him because they already knew that a crane thinking about a fish's welfare was unheard of. C. Words and meanings. Explain these words and expressions. A. Cast it on the ground. Throw it to the ground. B. It will be capital. It will be the best thing to happen. C. Told them all the glories. Described all the good things about. D. He is sharp enough in any situation. Is very clever or smart. E. It's unheard of. Not known to have happened before. F. Lost in thought. Not paying attention to anything happening around. 2. What activities links all these words? All these words are linked to eating. Bite, chew, dine, feed, graze, ingest, munch, nibble, peck at, pick. These words refer to eating at a slow pace. While attack, bolt, devour, chomp, gobble up, gorge, scoff, wolf. These words refer to eating greedily or quickly. Thanks for listening. For new videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you like my videos, please share and like.